All right, this is round three with Black-White Devotion. Apparently we're playing against Guile, not to be confused with the Street Fighter character Guile. Two different Guiles. I will mulligan this hand. I would like to mulligan this hand. I have 3-1 drops, though, so we're going to see if that does anything. On the draw, I could get some lands. That would be amazing. But then again, I could not as well. But I got these three dudes to play, so... Hey, that's a land. Not too shabby. Oh, Rakdos Cackler. I'm going to gain some life. I have protection from that dude. Interesting. I wonder what we're playing here. Oh, yeah. We're looking good. Dubs, Soldier of the Pantheon. See. If it's a land, I might just keep it up there just to hit Elspeth. Yeah, that's fine. You got it. Oh, actually a Johnny could be really good. Let's put that guy on top. Because I have 3 lands, that lets me play everything in my hand except for the Elspeth, which is pretty fine. He's got 4 cards. This guy's going to get Lightning Struck, I believe. He's a little good against their deck. I mean, whatever their deck is. Could be the, like, Fanatic of Mogus Brew with the Rakdos Aggro deck. Interesting. This is like the Toil. It's just like a really aggressive burn deck, which is interesting. 1, 2, 3. Make this guy bigger. Not gonna get in there when I got into Johnny. Interesting, take it. Wonder what you could have her for. Chandra Pyromancer? Pyromaster? Everyone calls her Chandra Oh, okay. That's fine. You got a Magma Jet. Like a child. You think you're somebody's friend, you know? Me and Guile go way back. We hang out. And, what do I get? You know, what do I get out of it? I get nothing. I get a Skullcrack to the Ajani. And then I get a Rakdos Cackler to the Ajani. Alright. Well, now we're going to play 2 Militants. So he's got 1 card left in hand, which is nice. He put both the cards he scryed for on the tippy top. So this is... I'm just going to block you. I feel like if I can minimize the damage I take against any of these aggressive decks, I'm just in good shape. 1, 2... Precinct Captain! Precinct Captain. What are you gonna do now? What are you doing? Lore Leader's Helix? Okay, that's fine. You got 1 card in hand? I'm feeling pretty healthy, to be honest with you. Alright, insta-pass. Now here's the question. Theoretically, if I play Banisher Priest right now, next turn I can untap. I will have 5 off of Nykthos. I can go 1, 2, 3, 5, and then I'll have 1 more off of Temple. So just by playing a Banisher Priest, it lets me play an Elspeth next turn if nothing else is killed. So we're going to try it. And then maybe I could be like, "Hey man, I'm just trying to put some pressure on the board, that's all." Oh, you're gonna get rid of what? What are you gonna do there? Nothing. All right, that was interesting. What did you do there? Looks like you just tapped the land. Oh, he double Boros Charmed me, and they got exiled, and I didn't even notice. Wow, what just happened? He drew like Boros Charm, Boros Charm, Lightning Strike to kill me for Xaxes? What in the earth? What? Ugh. All right, so Blood Baron comes in, Fiend Slayer comes in, Angel can leave. Take out two militants. That's pretty much all I want to do. I don't want to bring anything else really. Glare is not going to do much. Maybe Celestial Flare if he has like Boros Reckoner. Might be better than one spear. I have no idea. I think I'm just going to go like this. I just want the life gain, to be honest with you. Oh my god, Boros Charm Lightning Strike to take me from 11 to 0. That's degenerate. I will play first. Oh, this hand's alright. Yeah, you go to 6, you unfair degenerate. Alright. And next time I'm going to Johnny, which is pretty sweet. I feel like I should have the initiative here. Oh man. Magma Jet? I barely know her. That doesn't even make any sense. It's not even close to the sound that that joke is supposed to make. What does he put? Both on top. That's always terrifying when he puts both on top, because it's like, why would you do that? Why do you want these so badly? Alright, get in there. You think maybe that was one of his top cards. And then he put the other card back on top, which was like, oh my god, Magma Jet dot deck over here. Remember the time I was like, what did he just do? I saw him tap mana, but then nothing's in his graveyard. And then it was all exiled because of Dryad Militant, and I just was unable to see it. Yeah, that was something. I do like about a Johnny that even if you don't have any dudes, you can choose to select zero. It's because it's up, put a +1/+1 counter on up to one creature. So you can be like, I choose zero. I'll choose no creatures. No one is worthy of my counters. No, but for real though, they just don't exist. There's no dudes there. What is this guy doing? Let me tell you how much I like Spear of Heliod against, like, creatures. I think he's deciding whether to attack me or a Johnny. I'm a 20. That's healthy. Oh, yeah. So not only can I go Soldier, I can put a counter on him. I have Brave the Elements mana, and I can keep Spear up. I'm okay with these things. That guy's a 4-3? Good lord. That's my preview card. I like that. Alright, so three cards in hand. What do you do? Yep. I can't actually stop it. He might actually just attack it and then either Boros Charm or Searing Spirit. Not Searing Spirit. You know what I'm saying. Warlord's Helix targeting a Johnny, I would assume. Just really unfortunate. Because a Johnny doesn't really hurt anybody. He's a good dude. Because it dealt damage to you this turn. Yeah, so I can't even actually kill him that turn. We'll just go Priest-Saint Captain. He says, we'll just go Priest-Saint Captain, as if I made a choice, as if I was like, I have a lot of options this turn, but I'm just going to go Priest-Saint Captain. Truth be told, I had no options. And this guy's gonna make 2/2s? Ooh, snap. Token City! He's gonna die, isn't he? No, I got Brave the Elements. What do? 1 captain sent out to brave the elements. Coming this fall. War Leader's Helix, the story of Precinct Captain. Pro Red. Oh, that's a good one. Let's just play that now. I'll make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we'll go Elspeth. And I can see a concession in the future, I think. And he goes to 8 right now. Oh no, he took first strike damage, so. No, he didn't. He goes to 8. And I have 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I have 15 power on board. That seems good. I'm satisfied. What did you do? Which one did you do? You just made me discard. Did you make me discard? What did you do? What did he hit? He played Toll? Targeting himself? Oh, he drew 2 cards and lost 2 life. Okay, that's cool. I'm like, what does that side even do? Alright. So that card is basically just a 3 mana read the bones that you can't cast on. You can't actually scry. That seems fine. I think we're done. Alright, by done, I mean, I think we're good. I don't think we change anything. I didn't even draw any gain life cards. This hand is pretty bogus. Oh man, so good too. If I could draw a runner on lands, I don't even know how I could chip this hand. Oh, there's no way I can risk that though. Oh, that's a little better. This hand's real slow, but like, if Blood Baron survives, I should be golden. Cause he's golden! Rakdos Cackler? Ugh. This is a song called Flamenco Sketches by Miles Davis. It is on Kind of Blue, which is arguably the best jazz album ever recorded by the human race. So if you guys, whether you like jazz or not, you should definitely check out Kind of Blue. Because it is insane. And by insane, like, oh god, it's so good. Boros Charm me. Magma Jet me, that's even better. Like, it makes you feel like, this album makes you feel like you're this misunderstood artist living on the streets of New York. It's really good. It might be the best piece of music in the 21st century. Alright, so I play this guy, and no matter how he kills my Boros Reckoner, how did he scry? Put them both on top. I don't think he's ever put a card on the bottom with a scry. But if he wants to kill my Reckoner, then I trade it with a Cackler. He's gonna Boros Charm me. Oh god, I'm at 10. He's got 3 cards in hand. Is there a chance that I can like go land, keep this guy online? I don't know. Play this guy. So I think we can actually just attack with Reckoner here. He's not gonna block, but I want to try to get some aspect of racing in. What? Oh boy. Why can't I brave the elements myself? I'm a white creature. I'm I'm gonna guess bottom and top. Alright, so I imagine he hits some sort of Boros Charm combination. Some Boros Charm concoction. Anger of the Gods, that's pretty interesting. Can I Brave the Elements here for red? That's sick. Bloop. Now only his guy dies? Fantastic. 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll play Gideon here. Oh man, that Brave was sick. I don't think he has any haste guys that I can actually block, so we're just gonna get in there. And even so, I get a token, so. He's at 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have 8 power on board, not including a Gideon. I don't think he can kill me, but if he has War Leader's Helix, he's in better shape, at least. Alright, well. Well, that's a good dude. Let's see if it matters. So he goes up to 10, then he takes 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. He has to kill a 2-drop. Okay. Well, no other 2-mana spell could deal 5. So he might just actually be, might just be showing me what he has. Like, put me to 2. Okay. Oh, good game. All right, we won. Good game. I'm always so reluctant, even if like it's obvious that they lost. I'm like, oh god, does he know something I don't know? Is there like a 0-mana card that deals 2 damage that when you have no cards in your hand and your opponent's at 2, you could search it out of your library and shoot your opponent with it? Is that a thing that exists in Magic the Gathering? Is that how I'm gonna lose? I don't know. Okay. Well, anyway, we won. So, yeah.